This poem is called In the Droving Days by Banjo Paterson. Only a pound, said the auctioneer. Only a pound, and I'm standing here selling this animal, gain or loss. Only a pound for the drover's horse. One of the ones who was never afraid, one of the boys of the old brigade. Thoroughly honest and game, I swear, only a little the worse for wear. Plenty as bad to be seen in town. Give me a bid and I'll knock him down. Sold where he stands and without recourse. Give me a bid for the drover's horse. Loitering there in an aimless way, I somehow noticed the poor old grey. Weary and battered and screwed, of course, yet when I noticed the old grey horse, the rough bush saddle and the single rein of the bridle laid on the tangled mane, straightway the crowd and the auctioneer seemed on a sudden to disappear, melted away in a kind of haze, for my heart went back to the droving days. Back to the road, and I crossed again the endless miles of the saltbush plain, the shining plain that is said to be the dried-out bed of an inland sea, where the air, so dry and so clear and bright, refracts the sun with a wondrous light, and out on the dim horizon makes the deep blue gleam of the phantom lakes. At dawn of day, we could feel the breeze that stirred the boughs of the sleeping trees, and brought the breath of a fragrance rare that comes and goes on that scented air. For the trees and the grass and the shrubs contain a dry sweet scent on the saltbush plain. For those that love her and understand, the saltbush plain is a wonderland, a wondrous place where nature's ways were revealed to me in the droving days. We saw the fleet wild horses pass, and kangaroos in the Mitchell grass. The emu ran with her frightened brood, all unmolested and unpursued. But there rose a shout and a wild hubbub when the dingo broke for his native scrub. And he paid right dear for his stolen meals, with the drover's pack at his wretched heels. For we ran him down at a rattling pace, and the pack horse joined in the stirring chase, and a wild halloo at the kill we'd raise. We were light of heart in the droving days. 'Twas a drover's horse, and my hand again made a move to close on a fancied rein, for I felt the swing and the easy stride of the grand old horse that I used to ride. In drought or plenty, in good or ill, that same old steed was a comrade still. That old grey horse with his honest ways was a mate to me in the droving days. We kept our watch in the cold and damp, when the cattle broke from a sleeping camp, across the flat and over the plain, with my head bent down on his waving mane, with the boughs above and the stumps below, on the darkest night I could let him go at a racing speed. He would choose his course, and my life was safe with that old grey horse. But man and horse had a favourite job, when a scrubber broke from a station mob. With a right good will was the stock whip plied, and the old horse raced at the straggler's side, and the green-eyed whip such a wheel would raise. We could use the whip in the droving days. Only a pound. And was this the end? Only a pound for the drover's friend, the honest friend who had seen his day and now was worthless and cast away, with a broken knee and a broken heart, to be starved and flogged in a hawker's cart. Well, I made a bid for a sense of shame and the memories dear of the good old game. Guinea, thank you, and cheap at that, against you there in the curly hat. Only a guinea and one more chance, down he goes if there's no advance. Third and the last time, 1, 2, 3. And the old grey horse was knocked down to me. And now he's wandering fat and sleek on the loosened flats by the homestead creek. Oh, I dare not ride him for fear he'd fall. But he does a journey to beat them all, for though he scarcely a trot can raise, he can take me back to the droving days.